Hey, buddy, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Running of the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance series on a Saturday. We did have a video cross 5,000 likes with two more ready to go, getting very close to that mark, which now puts us at 177 over 180. It doesn't look like, unless something crazy happens today, lining up for tomorrow, it does not look like we're going to have all Beastie Week starting on Sunday. If it rolls over to the next week, then that's fine. I mean, luckily, you know, it's totally easily reschedulable, so it's not that big of a deal. But I want to say thank you all very much for making it possible. Either way, let's keep it going, Mosh Pit. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you, again, artwork of the day submitted by Circular Prism. Almost a week ago, title thread was, this sure was an upgrade from the last time I posted here. I absolutely love this one. I don't know why this one had so little upvotes, but I wanted to give it its due credit. And again, shout out to Circular Prism. Only 26 upvotes at the time of this recording, but definitely go check out the full resolution on the Sinvicta subreddit. And away we go. Now, really quickly, I was going to do the Sinvicta mod run today, but I didn't. I'll talk about that in a moment. Oh, boy. CJ is going to be Juliet 8, Victor Bravo, Charlie Romeo 2-6. The reason why I did it is because I actually had to disable all the mods. This turns into Quince, and then, it turns into, from here, from Quince, it turns into a card reading. Interesting. So obviously we're starting off with the spin down die, which is an amazing starting item and just an amazing item in general. One that you can keep for basically the entire run, and you know that you're going to get taken care of. It will spin down the item ID of the item pedestals, of all the item pedestals that exist in the room. So this is one of those times where I think it is completely necessary, not a convenience, but it's completely necessary to have the external information mod, because it will tell you exactly what spin down die is going to turn the, I was expecting that to hit the tinted rock. It will tell you exactly what spin down die is going to create out of you spinning down said pedestal. So the fact that we have a chance here to get the card reading is going to be a big deal, because if we get card reading, that gives us the opportunity to at the very least get a free secret room or a free item room. But more importantly than that, it also allows us to go straight to the boss on any given level, which means that, I mean, we're not going to try to speed run today, but that also means that we can almost guarantee get a free deal with the devil shot or deal with the angel shot no matter where we go. Take bag lunch. I mean, walnuts not too bad. I think bag lunch is a little bit better. And we are going to get the spin down die payout for card reading. Now, I'm not going to use it quite yet, because obviously we don't know what the boss is going to drop. If the boss drops something that is good enough for us to spin down, then, you know, we'll use it here instead. But I think that it's going to be tough to beat card reading, man. Card reading's really, really, really good. Sack dagger, tearing down old Dookie. And we'll take the safety pin. We definitely don't want the boomerang. We'll go all the way back here. But as we get rocking and rolling in this run here, I was going to do the Sinvicta character mod again for Saturday. I'm probably going to relegate that to Sunday, mainly because I had to disable all my mods during yesterday's Twitch stream because Isaac was constantly crashing over and over and over again. And then for this video, I just simply re-enabled the external information mod, and that's that. So I'll test it more tonight on stream. And another Curse of the Unknown. So we're just following the pattern from yesterday, I guess. We get a free item room or free secret room. I'm going to go in the item room, obviously, because we don't have any keys at all. I'll take Continuum. Actually, I didn't even see what Continuum was going to spin down into. I probably should have looked at that. You always want to make sure that you have a full charge on your... Well, it wouldn't have mattered anyway. We didn't have a full charge, so... although we could have gotten one and then spun it down again. I hope it wasn't something good. I don't think it was something good. I can never keep track of which ones you have to look out for the spin down die. That's something that, because I'm leaning so heavily on, hey, there's our key. I'm leaning so heavily on the external information mod, I don't have to memorize, like, hey, we got to look out for Red Stew or Steam Sale or, you know, blah, blah, blah. Speaking of Red Stew, man, yesterday's run was amazing. I honestly think that, like, that Red Stew is one of the best starting items that you can get. like, ever, like, period. Like, I think that it is so strong. If you have the tiers rate, and especially if you end up getting it combined with, like, say, an early Jacob's Ladder or early Death's Touch or something like that, some amazing tier effect, you might be able to carry that damage bonus all the way through, like, the mom fight if you're fast enough. If you get, like, mapping or something like that, then it just gets even better and better. So, you know, yesterday's run was just a lot of fun to do, and I'm glad a lot of people enjoyed it as well. Spindown Die is now currently ready to rock and roll. But with us not having any idea of how much HP we have, I know we have one soul heart that we picked up from the Tinted Rock on the first floor. That's it. This could be good here. I mean, it gave us a couple of cents and a few bombs and a key. And we just did a very odd-shaped Isaac circle there. It's a closed-off Isaac circle, which is just a square at that point. Piggy Bank turns into Black Lotus, which also turns into Gimpy, which also turns into Cricket's body. Would not mind Black Lotus, as that would give us a ton of extra HP, but we need to see what is going to be dropping out of the Devil Deal first. We can definitely get Black Lotus, for sure, 100%. Because there is the withdrawal machine, or donation machine, I should say, there. That's why I was kind of hoping that those golden chests were going to pay out with a little bit more money, so I wouldn't have to ding the donation machine, but it is what it is. Going to be Mons, bro, Duncanstan. Oh, it's going to be Black Monstro. Good damage on the Sack Dagger there. A little bit risky there. I was expecting him to jump. I was not expecting him just to slide next to the wall. There we go. Synthoil was too good to pass up. Okay, so I know that we have enough HP to take this. To take one of these anyway. But none of them are really worth... Ghost Baby turns into Celtic Cross. Bad PhD turns into Vade Retro. And Book of Sin turns into Little Chad. I think we're gonna go with Black Lotus just for the safety reasons of not having to worry about HP for a very long time. Yeah, Black Lotus, a 15 cent Black Lotus is real nice. I could buy the full charge, but okay, I'm going to go straight into the boss fight here. It's going to be against Bumbino. Almost always I'm going to be going to the boss fight no matter what, whenever we have card reading, just because I want to get the boss out of the way and I want to know exactly where the exit is to the level. I'm trying to make Bumbino jump into this bomb rock here, but he's not going to do that. He just has, like, the greatest AI of all time, apparently. Stem Cell turns into Dad's Key. I mean, we're not gonna take Dad's Key. the thing I love about Spindown Die is that you can have such a crazy run that you get so many more options from Spin Down Die than you normally would with, like, Chaos or even something like, you know, the D100. So Ventricle Razor turns into Tech X, and Tech X Continuum ain't bad. I'm more interested in seeing what our free item is over here. Well, free at the cost of a key. Monstro's Tooth is not worth it. I think Tech X is definitely the play here. Now, the other obvious, maybe not obvious downside to Spin Down Die is that with this particular combination, if we end up going for the boss room, that means that we have to secure a full charge before we use the card reading on the next floor. And I'm just now realizing our movement speed is also doo-doo. We've got a lot of HP. We could play the sack room down pretty well. The sack room potentially could also give us another nice spin down die target. That 0.88 movement speed is real scary. That could also pay for us getting the Tech X, because right now we're currently 6 cents short. I was kind of hoping that these golden chests in here was going to pay for that, but again, we get nothing but bombs out of our golden chests. Take the easy road here and shoot through the wall. Nice continuum. All right, game. Come on now. We just need 6 cents. Probably going to end up having to pay for the Tech X with the sacrifice room, which I really don't want to do because we're going to end up wasting all three of these soul hearts. But I guess at the end of the day, if we end up getting Tech X for it, then it's not a waste. All we do is we just need a nickel. This Invicta navigation is so bad that even when we go straight to the boss, we still do a full clear. I mean, to be fair, I'm only doing this just for us to get enough money to buy Tech X. That's all I'm really doing this for. Okay, that's a little bit better. Just need 2 cents. Might as well finish off the floor here. And, yeah, this prevents us from at least having to go play the, sack room. And that turns into Brimstone. I mean, I really, really, really need... I really need movement speed, but not... We're gonna not take Brimstone. Another nickel there, so we can actually buy Tech X still, because I think there's a full charge for sale as well. Yeah, blood bag is one of those the few items that I remember being good for Spin Down Die because of the presence of Brimstone. No, there's not a full charge. We cannot get Tech X, honestly. That kind of stinks, but at the same time, unless that's a 48-hour energy pill, which is probably not. Yeah, we'll take no. Spin Down Die is just too good. Fantastic. Amnesia. I say we go into the treasure room here. We Virgo, which turns into Cancer in 2 rolls. I mean, Virgo gives us positive pills, so, and the shield. I'm fine with that. Dreamcatcher turns into Blood Puppy, turns into Soap. Pay to play is also not terrible here, especially with us not having a whole lot of keys. I wouldn't mind getting a tears up either. My god. Okay, we're back to 15 cents. Yeah, and as you see here, the movement speed is just going to be an even bigger problem as this run progresses here, but thankfully Brimstone means that we don't have to maneuver all as much as we would normally need to, because we can just simply fire through the walls with Continuum. So that means that we don't have to be so precise in our positioning. Now, what would be crazy is if we can get another blood bag here. There's a charge beggar, though. This charge beggar is interesting because this will allow us to have two spin downs. And that's not something that you always get. Yeah, see, that doesn't help us, buddy. I need you to naturally charge this spin down die. There you go. I think it's still possible for it to pay out with the blood bag. Virgo Shield is going to last a while. This is perfect for us. Get ourselves a lucky penny there as well. Okay. So we've got two spin down die now. Two spin down die rolls, that is. So we can get the tiers upgrade from the shop. Assuming that we get the money back to pay for it from the other temperance machine, which we should be able to get. Okay. Let's see forever. Okay. Gives us free access to the secret room, the super secret room. What is this? We Horf. We definitely need to get a little bit more damage would be great. Again, as we talked about on not yesterday's episode, but the day before, the scaling with Brimstone is just so good. You get damage upgrade with Brimstone, you're going to be just destroying everything. And that's what I love about the item. And if you can stack those damage upgrades early on, man, you are set for, well, the life of the run anyway. I was going to say set for life, but like that's not entirely true. They're combined the damage with Sack Dagger, Brimstone. There we go. We get the tiers up anyway. We're just going to get rock bottom, I guess. Before we do that, let's just go see what's in the Angel deal. Nothing that we care about. If we get rock bottom and hallowed ground, that's just going to be tasty. Yeah, this is the stats. These are the stats that we can expect when we get rock bottom here. So we're gonna go one, two, bam. Rock bottom. You don't see it too often. But oh man. So rock bottom is gonna prevent us from losing stats. Essentially, it sets a new baseline stat floor is just how to think of it anyway. There are times where you cannot, basically our stats can't go down. Just think of it that way. And it's a fantastic item, definitely one of the standouts in all of Isaac. And it's also one of the most annoying items to actually get and unlock. There we go. Looking for another. Yeah, there we go. I'm a little bit sad actually that there's not any red hearts on the entire level. Black tooth, no thank you. Could go in the curse room, but we're getting a little spicy here if we go too far lower on the HP. So I'm not gonna tap the temperance machine to activate Hallowed Ground. I mean, we're going to naturally get hit. That's what I was looking for. I was looking for the super secret room. honestly, I think that it betters us to re-roll Guppy's tail into Guppy's paw. I think that that's better. Lump of coal wouldn't be too bad. Now we can go in the curse room. In really long, extended early floors here. Seems to be the name of the game for the last couple of runs. But, I mean, you know, you got to do what you got to do. I'm going to tap this just so we can get the hollow ground buff. So there you go. So now notice how our damage and our damage and our tears rate is not going to fall despite us not being in hollow ground anymore. So we now have just raised our tears rate by a whole lot and our damage by a decent amount. And that's the benefit of rock bottom there. And that is ultimately the reason why I think rock bottom is one of the greatest items in all of Isaac. You know, straight to the boss here. It's going to be Sister's Vist. Now, we don't have a full charge on the spin down die. That's okay. We got the big payout that we wanted from this type of build here. We're going to get a range upgrade. I'm actually going to wait for us to get the movement speed upgrade. We're just going to get Sacred Heart, I guess. Okay. Yeah. So we're looking real strong now. You can have the Horf. Wow, Sacred Heart out of nowhere. We didn't have to spin down die for it. Oh, baby. And with us having rock bottom, I actually kind of wish we didn't have Brimstone now at this point. I know it's weird to hear me say that. But I kind of wish we didn't, because with Sacred Heart, Rock Bottom, Hallowed Ground, we've canceled out any sort of need for like a tears up, tier effects even. I mean, we're laughing here. Turns to a forget me now, but we would have to lose spin down die, and that is just not going to happen. All we're really looking for is just like a full charge here. Excuse me one moment. Sorry about that. I had somebody come to the door. PhD turns into the quarter, which means that we could get champion belt. I mean, let me go back here just to see. It's actually, so what's funny about pausing recordings and stuff. What's funny about pausing recordings and stuff is that you all don't know how much time has gone by, but it's actually been like 25 minutes. That's forgive me now. So it's an instantaneous pause for you all, but for me, like 25 minutes has gone by, I need to reacclimate. So I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna spin this. Oh yeah, it does that, doesn't it? Well, I'm gonna take the quarter anyway. We need 3 cents. See, I'm all discombobulated now. Honestly, losing champion belt is not that big of a deal. I do want the quarter though. See what this can we cannot get that. Okay, so I'm gonna go back here and see if we can get the last 2 cents that we need now. Hopefully he's gonna be here. That works too. Binky I will take. Binky is gonna give us a little bit of HP. It's not gonna give us the tears up. Now you might be wondering how come we don't get a tears up. Well, the reason why we don't get a tears up despite us having rock bottom is because our tears rate is already pretty much capped for now. Until we get something more major that shows up, we are not going to be able... Oh, I'm going to bomb myself. It's inconsequential for me to do this because there's also 2 soul hearts in here. So I'm just making sure we get the money out of that golden harp. But because of the way the rock bottom works, we would have to get a tiers rate increase that surpasses what we already have now, which is not going to happen. So we're going to pay 15 cents to gain 10 cents, basically. So we're going to go up to 33 cents here. Ball bandages doesn't turn anything into spectacular that we want. We are finally ready to head on down. So again, sorry about the discombobulation of this floor here. I had to take care of the door. I didn't have to hold the door. I just had to simply take care of the door. Someone was at the door. And now that I think about it, me getting the full charge was so we can get a speed upgrade here, which we didn't get, but oh well. Again, discombobulated. Okay, so we have two options. We could go straight to the mom fight or go to the item room. Obviously, we're going to go to the item room here. Oh, man. Okay, kidney stone. Will kidney stone work? I don't know if kidney stone will work with rock bottom and brimstone necessarily. Take a look at this real quick here. Okay, so 4.5 volt wouldn't be bad of a pickup for us at all. We do not want car battery. Car battery would absolutely ruin a spin down die. I'm going to assume that kidney stone doesn't work. We have to go through mega as well, which means we need to get a total of two separate full charges here, which may or may not be possible. It should be possible considering that we've got 4.5 volt. Okay, there's our full card. It's actually pretty impressive that I didn't even move the other bomb that was on the other side of there. I couldn't be able to do that if I tried. So the 4.5 volt will charge up our spacebar item based on us dealing damage to enemies. The more damage we deal, the faster it charges. If you look in the top left-hand corner. I would say 9 times out of 10, the 4.5 volt does work in your favor in terms of net gain on getting yourself extra charges out versus like just simply going around and clearing floors or clearing rooms rather. So we no longer gain charges whenever we clear a room on our spacebar item. But we do usually benefit more out of us. Yeah, we're going up here, us dealing damage. So we're going to try to get try to get kidney stone. I don't believe that it works with brimstone. But obviously, kidney stone and rock bottom is like one of the best combos that you can have. Because it just gives you so much tears rate. It's a shame that we're not going to get the boss rush either, but it is what it is. Could take your soul here for one free devil deal. Let's go back and let's grab your soul. Again, I'm not overly concerned right now about getting kidney stone yet, because I know that we'll be able to fill up spin down die by fighting mom. You hear the pips go off. We're already at a full charge here. I don't think we could have gotten a second, but we definitely could have gotten very easily gotten one. Okay, so this is just going to be the test. Again, I'm almost positive that this is not going to work with brimstone, but could be wrong. Yeah, so kidney, and the thing is that kidney stone is just not going to proc with brimstone. That's what I mean when I say it's not going to work. So no big surprise there. It's okay. We didn't really lose much out of it either, because we didn't get a devil deal. Did not get any sort of other target for spin down die, so it is what it is. But we do take the negative, which is going to give us a nice damage upgrade. I will leave no here for now, because remember, we have spin down die, obviously. So if we do end up finding an item that we just don't want, especially if it's a space bar item, we can just simply nope on out of there. That's what I like to see. Go straight to the bosses here. And this is where the strength of card reading really starts to take shape. Keep an eye on the charge of spin down die here when we get a full spread of damage on Skolex. And that is a 73% deal with the devil miss. And I guess we're just going to take the pentagram and, yeah, head on down. So we don't get the portal to the boss room this time around, but we do gain the free entry to the secret room, which is still pretty good. More often than not, you're not going to find too many juicy targets to roll through on the womb and beyond. So the fact that we, you know, got a free secret room out of it's okay. Matchstick. I mean, it's not really that great. And our tears rate, I believe, is already soft capped by rock bottom with us having brimstone. I am going to go into the curse room here just to see what's in. What we got going on. Spin down die, ready to go once again. Sacred Heart, Brimstone, being the dream combo that they've always been. Like if we have a better spoon bender, and that's also gonna be a dead end. All right. Gotta itch my nose. Oh man. Whenever you have brimstone, you've got over a 2-tier delay. That is just you're on easy street at that point. Mr. Boom turns into the poop, which turns into the Necronomicon, which turns into the Book of Belial. I think we're just gonna hold out here for something good from the boss, assuming we ever find it, of course. That's another sort of extra little bonus about rock bottom, is that if you have rock bottom and you start taking pills, even if you don't have Virgo, the pill down effects cannot hurt you, except for like bad trip and health down. But I mean, you can't get it, like a speed down is not going to affect you, a tears down is not going to affect you, no stat downs will affect you, which is the whole strength of rock bottom, is just not allowing your stats to go anywhere but up. There's a guaranteed devil deal, and boy howdy is it a good one. Thankfully, we get to go straight to Stanley here. Now, what's nice about Your Soul here is that we are able to get a free item from the Dark Chest as well. So it's not just devil deals. It's any deal that gives you, essentially, that gives you an option to pay with your health for items. Oh man, the chunkage is real. Take perfection, keep our luck up, and head on down. All right, and here we go. I have a cult, duality, sacrificial altar, and incubus. I think you gotta take incubus here, right? Gotta take Incubus. I have a cold. It's kind of annoying. I honestly really would not mind the movement speed upgrade from Orphan Socks. I'm just going to be honest with you. It turns into Trisagion. That turns into Jacob's Ladder. We should be able to get a full charge from damage. But will we get three of them? I don't know. Keep in mind, I'm sacrificing our boss portal here on Curse of the Lost, no less. Try to get Jacob's Ladder. Undefined turns into a whole bunch of nothing. Nine lives turns into the Pact. I will take nine lives, though, because we do have two or three for Guppy. Revelations, might as well grab ourselves a good old fashioned. We'll take the blanket. So we need to go through two more rolls. Oh my god. What is with C-section showing up all the time? I mean, look, I'm gonna take it. C-section Brimstone again. I ain't gonna turn down. That was a naturally occurring C-section as well, which is a very, very ironic statement to say if you think about it too much, which you really shouldn't. You should never think about anything out of context in Isaac, like, for too long. You might actually be thrown in jail. C-section Continuum Brimstone Sacred Heart. Good lordy. Take Scapular here. Strength card, we can go and use the strength card just to give us a little bit extra boost there. You see that we've gained permanent stats. One more gets us Jacob's Ladder. Spider Butt turns into Poly Freaking Femus. That would be better than Jacob's Ladder. But I don't know if we're going to get... I'm not sure if we're going to get enough full, of a full charge here. I should check this to see if this is a full charge. There's a Hermit card. No idea where we were taken. Okay. Okay. All right. Am I going insane? Or is there just no way to go on this level? I think we gotta go. This is greed here that we're talking about now. I think I'm gonna go for Polyphemus. Actually, we can get. I know what the play is. If we don't get another full charge, we can go into the Mega Satan door and then die, while still having letting the damage charge spin down die up. But it doesn't matter because we were about to get it. We might even get Jacob's Ladder too, actually. Let's go back and get our prize here of Polyphemus. Which is not where I think it's over here, right? Yeah. Poly freaking Femus. Just like, you know, casual 24.45 damage upgrade. You know, nothing too crazy. Chub room here. That would also just be a full charge, so that also works. gonna get Jacob's Ladder. And yeah, that is a really, 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 really powerful build that we've got. As a foundation here, we are smoking. The C-section babies are just gonna get even bigger. Golden teleporter. Yeah. That's some power right there. If you're not having a good time, I don't know what you're doing. Second run. Tay 8 Ozef. So I think we're gonna take the oh yeah, that's right. On a victory lap, if you have card reading on the victory lap, the first floor does not work with card reading. Don't ask me why. Yeah, I wouldn't mind getting Tech X here if we could. I'm a mega. Is there a full charge in there? There's not. Wait, what does Fanny Pack turn into? Fanny Pack turns into Humbling Bundu. Shot speed up. It's going to be very good for us having Brimstone. So we are not going to have enough for Tech X again. Sad face. Unless it's a full charge that drops, we're not going to have it, so... I don't know if Tractor Beam does anything with this C-section. No, it doesn't. And now we're gonna fly. We're gonna zoom through this. Just because we can. Movement speed upgrade I will take, just because we definitely need it. And there's our Guppy item right there. And... I can get Goathead, which is no big deal at all. But we end up getting Guppy. Guppy's going to absolutely crush this run. Oh, baby. And sure, we'll also take Twisted Pear. Because, you know, on a run like this, you know, you just need more... And you need more items, you know? You need more shots. Okay, so we don't get a red portal this time around, and that's fine. Horror Babylon would not be too bad. Skinny Mushroom would also not be too bad either. Oh, my God. We may have to intervene here and disable Jacob's Ladder. This is Birthright, because, I mean, hell, why not at this point? And that turns into Uranus, Dogma, and Dunce Cap. Where are you seeing Box of Friends? Oh, okay. Honestly, I'm just going to take Uranus and Spider Mod, buddy. Yeah, I'm just going to take the full charge here. I'm going to take that as well. Oh, the continuum. The continuum shots, man. You have access to the boss trap room, which is something that you don't see every day. I think Mr. Dolly. Sometimes it's good for a couple extra little hits of HP here and there. Sometimes not. This time around, we only got one soul heart, and that's fine. Now, we don't have Holy Mantle. The reason why you saw it on the boss fight is because we had the blanket, which gives us a holy mantle charge every time we go fight a boss. And here's to hoping that we get some mapping, because good lord. I love that we just don't even have to fire. We don't have to fire anything. We just simply get, you know, Buddy Gus. Sure, why not? I don't know if we're ever going to take damage, but if we do, we're going to get money for it. By money, I mean you get money stats for it. Next scab we'll go ahead and take here. It's going to be Krampus, which gives us a lump of coal. And I think we'll work with C-section, maybe. But this might be one of the most dominant boss rushes that you ain't ever seen. Don't want key bum. Don't want sensor. We're gonna lose the soul heart either way. Honestly, I would love to see what this does to Old Beast. You know, it's a Saturday. We got ourselves a super overpowered run. Hey, champion belt, welcome back. I like that Uranus is just activating like instantly now. As soon as we walk into the room, everything just freezes instantly. Normally, that's a damage-based proc. Did not see where the tinted skull was. I was looking for it. The only even reason why we want to get the tenant skull is because obviously we want to go fight Old Beastie. Well, I tried. Lover's card doesn't really matter. There it is. Now this might look like actual like death if we're playing with just simply one HP. And yeah, if we get hit by like a bomb or like, you know, explosive diarrhea or something like that, then yeah, of course we're gonna get hit for death. But keep in mind that we have overwhelming amounts of damage. That turns into Mom's Knife. I think we're going to go ahead and pass on that. Tech Zero. I think it does work with C-section. Yeah. Oh, boy. This is going to get out of hand in a hurry. Hey, you know, today's a good day. All right, there's fortune cookie, and that turns into sulfur. Honestly, I'm down with the sulfur. We get the Leviathan transformation, and let's just go for it. Old Beastie's not going to know what hit her. Old Beastie. Tinted Rock over here. So Sulfur is going to stack with our Brimstone effect. And on top of that, if you didn't know, Sulfur also happens to have a damage upgrade built into it every time you use it. So it's just super duper worth using and getting, especially if you have Brimstone, and even more especially than that if you've got Rock Bottom. Go check the store real quick, see if we can get an extra little Soul Heart or two. Yeah. Got blue map as well, which I hope that we're going in the right direction for the boss. And away we go.
Spent it. It's gone. Just get over it.
How can you have spent Mulligan.
Gotta go Mulligan here. I don't know if it stacks with the guppy transformation anymore. But anytime we can create more flies, for the better. Wow, that was a really quick floor.
He's self-destructive.
Only 8 minutes on this victory lap, too. I think that would actually be not wise. We don't have explosion immunity. The brimstones would explode, but the C-section babies wouldn't. They would just be poisonous. But we don't need like any more damage. I hate to say it. It sounds really weird. I know, but we really don't need any more damage. Especially somewhat of a questionable call here. If we were to take Ipecac. You know it's good damage whenever you can instantly freeze the mega enemies. So there's the entire second floor there. Well, third floor. Here's the second floor. Looking forward to seeing what Sulfur does against Old Beastie. Now, one thing I will say, because I realize that people are going to be saying in the comments, yes, I could have been using Sulfur this entire time, and then we could have been gaining even more and more damage, because obviously with Rock Bottom, it's going to stack up. But again, as I was talking about, the reason why we didn't take Ipecac is we just don't need any more damage, so I'm not even honestly even sweating it. We're just here to smash Dogma and Beastie. And wrap this one up. Imagine needing like damage and you had to come to Dogma, and then you see Mom's Knife at the very, very end of the run. All right, well, good luck, Dogma. You're gonna need it. All right, there's phase one. All right, that's Dogma. And now the real fun can begin. Here we go, Sulfur has been popped. We can't see the stats anymore, and I don't think you need to. Oh no. I think War is probably going to die instantly. Yeah. There goes Death. And so thanks for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed that run. I don't see why you wouldn't have been able to, because man, it was an incredible run for sure. So, and down goes Old Beastie. Thank you for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you click that like button, leave a comment down below. Let me know what your favorite C-section synergy is. And again, thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing, everyone. I hope you had a fantastic start to your Saturday, like that run right there. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. Like, thanks to patrons of mine like Known Roach, Jose Zen, Daniel Kwan, Mark J. Cameron, Matt Blandford, and Warren Hosinian. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.